wasn't happy, but you have a couple of people here who can answer your questions. Continuing the question to my previous Georgian colleague, well, just have a quick look how the auction happens. I will just quickly show you, because you had a question, and later on you will see that we did have some Georgian influences in the Ukrainian reform. Just quickly, yeah, so this is the auction. I will just quickly switch it to English so you can see. But this is the auction which is happening now in Ukraine. That's how it looks. The bidders can see each other. They see that there are other bidders. They see their prices, but they can't see who it is. And as soon as the auction is over, and it will be after round three, all information at that moment it becomes open. So submission and everything related to the publication. Okay, it was a short introduction. Now I go back to the presentation, which is not even open here. But it's not. Okay, and now we start the presentation. The first question, which usually should be answered, why people or do some things or changes happen. And being honest, I would never think that I would be in the public procurement department half a year, a bit more than half a year ago. But now we are somehow here and presenting the reform, the e-public procurement reform, which is happening in Ukraine. The reason for this was very simple. It was Revolution of Dignity, which we had in Ukraine in 2014. Why public procurement and why the Revolution of Dignity? Because, first of all, Alexander Stardubtsev, who was also, basically, somewhere in the crowd, all of us are somewhere there in the crowd on one or another side.
You should tag yourself there.
I think that this day, and we had just 2 days, I was somewhere on the right in the corner because our camp was there. But then after the revolution, first of all, Alexander thought that, okay, we started this mess, we need to continue it somehow. Why was public procurement chosen as a sphere to apply the knowledge and energy? Because this revolution was not for Europe or against anyone, it was for dignity. Because public officials stole a lot of money, and it was very easy to see that something is wrong in there, because they were living for sure beyond their means. And public procurement is one of the spheres where they could steal a lot of money. According to our estimations, every year it's around, the data are based on 2014, and we estimated at least 20% are stolen, 10% to corruption, and 10% due to the inefficient competition. Because suppliers don't go into public procurement when they know that everything is predecided even before they think about taking part in public procurement. And then this money goes for financing political parties and so on and so on. It's quite a big chunk of money, which is more than $2.2 billion. And then there was a need for the logic, which logic to apply, or which philosophy or ideology to apply for the reform. Because do we have problems with the level of professionalism in Ukraine? Yes, we do. Do we have a problem with price-quality ratio? Yes, we do. Do we have problems with over-regulation? Yes, we do. We have a lot of problems in the public procurement, as any country. Maybe more, maybe less. Do we need to address them? Yes. But the matter is of focus. The whole focus of the current reform is on this. It's on $2.2 billion, which we are losing each year, and then which are reinvested into doing bad things. And it happens because somehow many people tend to believe that government is quite good at controlling and making governments efficient. That's why we have a lot of controlling bodies. At least in Ukraine, we have 8 controlling bodies, which to one or another extent are involved in supervising the public procurement procedures. Somehow we wanted to change the ideology because we believe that parents of the kid which goes to the kindergarten are much more interested in making proper monitoring of the procedures than any public officials. Public servants are lazy overall. And it just matters. They don't have a proper motivation to control it properly. So the key thing was to give tools to everyone willing to control to do it. As I said, it started after the Revolution of Dignity, and the reform was done and still being done to a great extent by, as one newspaper said in Ukraine, crazy volunteers. Why e-procurement was and still is a big part of the reform? Starting from the previous point, that the most important thing is to empower people and give tools for them to control it. Everyone sees everything. For sure, Tato and David, who were fathers of the public procurement reform, they were quite soon in Ukraine. And they helped a lot to develop the ideology behind the reform. At the same time, from 200 to 300 people worked on the reform at different times. Here you see Alexander standing and presented it to the president, then already the president, the first concept. And it was at the point when almost everyone in Ukraine had a feeling, and it was a duty for him to say that it's not possible and don't try to get into this field. In the end, it led to a triangle, and the whole ideology of the reform is based around this triangle, because we have public regulator, so we have the government. And you will see in the reform, in the scheme of the Prozoro system, which is the e-procurement system, which has been currently developed in Ukraine, already functioning, as you saw in the very beginning, there is a central database which belongs to the state, and the state is responsible for data storage, for control, and the auction is also happening there. And the state is overall responsible for setting the rules. Then we have commercial platforms which are linked to the central database. And all data, all information in the system are synchronized through the central database. So if contracting authority publish announcement on one a commercial platform, then the information will be seen on all others. We already have like 6 platforms, 5 are in the process of joining. Why them? Because first of all, in the very beginning, no one had any money to start the reform and to start designing the system. So the commercial platforms, since they were convinced to go with the people who wanted to change it, they invested their money in the beginning. But then there is another thing. They are business. Business does not believe to public officials. That's the thing in Ukraine. The level of trust is extremely low. We have traveled, we have been to 22 regions or oblasts in Ukraine over the last three months presenting the e-procurement system and the reform which is happening, but the level of trust, still we are from the business, now we are in the government, but the level of trust is still very low. But commercial platforms, they are business, and we believe that they better understand the needs of suppliers, they can better communicate the things which are needed to be communicated, and overall, they are better at responding for their requirements. So the interaction with suppliers and contracting authorities is left to commercial platforms. And then there is someone who has to monitor all the procedures. I will show you, and overall, I will focus a bit in the end on showing the BI tools which we have now. And BI tools now belong to Transparency International Ukraine, which is one of the most recognized and known anti-corruption organizations in Ukraine. And these BI tools will always belong to them. because the NGO society, there is also a special steering committee which will consist of different NGOs and representatives, but the key goal is to have the monitoring part on the NGO side and to eliminate it. Actually, this was the first two sections which were cancelled by Alexander Department and the department when he came, because the current version of monitoring is not the best one, the previous one, the one which existed. Just shortly, what is pilot e-procurement system Prozoro? As I said, so this is a central database, commercial platforms, and through commercial platform, both bidders and contracting authorities interact. Then all information automatically, so API, it gets into the BI tools, which I'm going to. Which are the advantages of our system, which we believe? First of all, it's written on open code. So as soon as we develop the system, and we'll develop it soon, any country which wants to have an e-procurement system, they can go to GitHub, download it, make necessary modifications, and use it free of charge. It's not proprietary, because we believe in open data, we believe in open code. Besides, the system is designed with open contracting data standard, which is an international one of the international standards promoted by the World Bank for data comparison. Second thing of the Prozoro is compulsory auction for effective price reduction. And of course, transparency of the process, the whole process, and competition among platforms to improve services. Overall, the system is now is already showcased in learning project for open contracting, and we do interact quite closely with them. Okay, Prozoro pilot results. You know that we had to send presentations earlier, so they are too old. And now I will just show you a couple of things on BI, because I will focus less on the Prozoro system. Overall, I will focus more on the BI tools, which help to monitor data in the system. I was also told that I have 15 minutes, but... yes, and... Yes, unfortunately, this version also, we have two BI models. Yeah, overall, people usually like to hear things about money and the amount of money. The system which has been developed, overall its price until now a bit less than $300,000, which we believe is still nothing for this kind of things. Also, we have two business intelligence tools which were provided by Click. They were provided free of charge because the representative of the company was an active participant of Maidan, so of the Revolution of Dignity, so he went to the office and begged for some licenses. We got them. We have two types of models, and then his company developed all data and accommodated them to the needs. We have two models. One of them is public, and this model is open to anyone willing. So bi.prozoro.org, anyone willing can go and see. Unfortunately, this model is only in Ukrainian. It's still a matter of time. We'll have it in different languages. But in this data, you already can find any information which you want. For instance, I don't know, if you want to change to choose tenders of Minister of Defense, and this is the Minister of Defense, you will need to trust me. But I can't.
Use Google Translator, no, in fact.
This one is only in Ukrainian, but then the next one I will show it also in English. That one is more complicated. But this one, unfortunately, is okay. So,
Demo.
Just a second, sorry. It's quite big. The application is quite big, and it was not using it for a bit. That's why I need to refresh it.
That doesn't to work.
That we choose Ministry of Defense. Then we can look at the ministry itself or any organizations which report to the Ministry of Defense. Let's say that we will just look at the Ministry of Defense. Then these are, for instance, the procurements which finished in the process of qualification, let's say at the one which were finished. Then we can go to, this is the overall indicators, and then we can look by geography. We can do actually any kind of analysis. Let's say we'll go to the tenders, which were in this regard. We can see the key information, which tenders cap happened, identificator, when the procurement was announced, who was the winner. And then, for instance, if we look at this tender, we can always go to the participants, who were the participants. We can look at the plant amount, at the sum of the tender, and so on and so on. From this application, you can't directly go to the documents of the documentation, but you can always look for the tender identificator and then go to any of the platforms and download the data. This is the public tool which is available to everyone. Now I will scare you a bit because there is also more complicated and advanced one. And this BI tool will be available only for anti-corruption NGOs, for investigative journalists, for controlling authorities. And here you can actually see any type of information. You can write codes, download all the necessary information. It's quite scary, as you might see. Overall, you can look at the inquiry, you can search the tenders by the inquiry start date, by end date, tender end date, auction date, qualification date, cancellation date, by the organizers, agencies. You can undertake any type of analysis. I don't know, for instance, let's see at the completed tenders. Just any of them.
Number of tenders.
So then you select all the, like, I mean, you can play this data here as
you wish,
anyone wants and wish. And besides, exactly on this BI model, we are trying to develop a red flag system, which will automatically
alert,
notify on a tenders prone to corruption. And it will be the first sign for investigators to look deeper into those tenders. For instance, I think I've run out of the time, but I would really like to show as much as possible from that BI. It does not work.
If you don't mind, I would much more prefer if you could answer my questions.
Last slide, and then a very small short video, very short, and then we go to the questions. So, next steps in the monitoring. Apart from monitoring, there are a lot of other directions which are happening currently in Ukraine. The focus of the forum is on monitoring. So, first of all, we are already working on an automatic red flags risk management system, which will identify tenders prone to corruption. Then the next step will be an investigation of suspicious tenders by civil activists and controlling authorities, and we'll need to develop certain manuals to educate them, to teach and show them how you can do it properly. Then we'll need to set up a mechanism on reporting of it, on investigation results, and teach them how to follow up on corrective measures which might happen. And then last very small thing. As we discussed a lot about KPIs. KPIs exist in monitoring and we can discuss them further. We are already working on some of them. But overall, for the procurement system in Ukraine, currently, we have the one and KPI is the number of bidders, especially of new bidders, in the system. As I said, the key problem which we have is corruption. Corruption leads to very low trust of the business. And it's almost impossible to convince, it's difficult to convince. The number of them is now grown, but it's still quite difficult. That's why one of our key activities is on trying to promote the reform, to promote the procurement system, and show that there are changes. Come and join and help us. Because our role is not to change everything. Our role is to give tools to everyone to change the system together. And in the end, I will show you a small promo which we have just released like 1 week ago. Unfortunately, it's in Ukrainian. But this promo in cartoons is going to tell about that now the procedure, it's a short plot. So that the procedure is full of paper, it's difficult to control, it's difficult to submit, it's difficult to get the data. The system is full of corruption because it's difficult just to control, impossible to control. And then it explains how you can join the system, and then it's very easy and simple. So just as... Yes. And, yes. Moreover, if anyone is interested, surely we have a stream in YouTube related to Prozoro, where you have a lot of information. And besides, Facebook is the easiest way to contact any of the government officials now, by the way.
Шукаєте нові ринки збуту для своїх товарів чи послуг? А знаєте, хто найбільший покупець в Україні? Та витрачає 33 мільйони в рік на меблі, 1,3 мільярда на одяг, 4,9 мільярда на продукти, купує навіть атомні реактори та багато іншого. Держава. Досі не брали участі в державних закупівлях? Бо чули про стару систему і не вірите, що вона змінилася. Прозоро доводить, що можна торгувати з державою просто та чесно. Раніше треба було зібрати купу довідок і довідок на довідки про довідки. З Прозоро готувати документи стало значно легше, адже більшість з них ви отримуєте за лічені секунди онлайн. Раніше складна процедура торгів, скажені вимоги, як документи мають бути складені, пронумеровані, шиті, а ще має боліти голова, щоб доставити їх вчасно, щоб жоден папірець не загубився. З Прозоро не треба нікуди йти. Всі документи надаються онлайн. Раніше підозрілі схеми з вибором переможця. З Прозоро усі документи відкриті. Після завершення тендеру можна подивитися, що пропонували конкуренти, і навіть скаргу подати онлайн. Тож чому б не спробувати продавати державі з Прозоро? Заходьте на сайт Прозоро в розділ «Почати роботу». Оберіть майданчик. Оберіть свою категорію, приміром, це меблі. Підпишіться на розсилку та чекайте інформацію про актуальні тендери. О, є цікавий. Подайте свою пропозицію онлайн. Візьміть участь в аукціоні, запропонуйте найкращу ціну та виграйте. Розширюйте ринки збуту одним кліком. Продавайте більше. Понад 90 тисяч закупівельних організацій по всій Україні. Заробляйте більше з Прозоро.